In this Cricut tutorial, I am showing you how to quickly and easily screen print with the help of your Cricut cutting machine and some permanent vinyl. So let's get crafty. Hey, I'm Michael from the Mr. Crafty Pants YouTube channel, where I show you Cricut tips, tricks, and tutorials every single week. And today I'm over here again on the Design Bundles YouTube channel because, well, we have partnered up to bring you all another Cricut tutorial. So be sure that y'all stay tuned until the very end of today's episode because y'all do not want to miss out on a single Cricut minute, especially today because, well, we are screen printing with the help of our Cricut cutting machine. Now, I'm using my Cricut Maker, but you could just as easily do this with a Cricut Joy or a Cricut Explorer or really any type of cutting machine as long as it works with SVG cut files. We are also going to need some permanent vinyl, and this stuff right here is honestly my go-to. This is the StarCraft HD. HD stands for high durability, and I actually get mine from 143 vinyl. This stuff is just so good. Along with that, we're also going to need some transfer tape, and in my opinion, y'all, this is the gold standard. This stuff is so good. This is the medium tack transfer tape. I also get this from 143 vinyl, and in my opinion, there is honestly nothing out there quite like it. It's just so good. This, as well as everything else that I'm using or mentioning, will be listed and linked for you all down in that description box below, so be sure to check all that out after this video is over. Along with that, we are also gonna need a mesh screen like this guy right here. This is from Speedball. And honestly, really any type of mesh screen should be able to do the job for you, but I am using the Speedball brand. And I am also using this squeegee right here. This is also from Speedball, but honestly, any type of squeegee will also do the trick. I just really like the size of this guy right here. We're also gonna need some painter's tape to go along with our mesh screen, which will make a little bit more sense here in just a little bit, but I'm using just plain Jane, regular old painter's tape. We're also gonna need something to actually set in our design, and for that, I am actually using an easy press too, but you could just as easily do this with a heat press as well. And of course, we cannot forget our screen printing ink. I also get this from Speedball. This stuff is amazing as well. I just really like this stuff all around. And last but definitely not least, we're also gonna need an SVG cut file to bring all this stuff together. And for that, I'm heading over to designbundles.net. And this is the SVG bundle right here that I'm using for today, this craft bundle. It does come with 9 designs, and honestly, I love all 9 of these. However, I am going with this one right here, this Eat, Sleep, Craft, Repeat SVG cut file. Now, per usual, I cannot make any promises by the time that you actually watch this video what this price is actually going to be, but at the time of filming this, it is marked down half off from $4.50 to $2.25. So let's head over now to Cricut Design Space and get started. And here we are on the Design Space canvas. And as you can see, I've already downloaded this from designbundles.net and uploaded it onto our Cricut Design Space canvas. Now, the first thing I want you to take a look at is right over here on the right-hand side of the page in the layers panel. This SVG cut file is split up into multiple layers. So we're actually gonna fix that because, well, ultimately we're creating a stencil with our permanent vinyl. And so we especially do not need multiple layers for that. So since this is all selected already, I can just simply come down here towards the bottom right-hand side of the page, and let's go ahead and select weld. Let's just turn that all into one single solid layer, just like that. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is actually resize this to fit onto our t-shirt. Now, for that, I'm coming over here towards the top left-hand side of the page and clicking on templates. And then I'm gonna do a search up here on the top right-hand side of the page for shirts. And I'm simply gonna select the classic t-shirts, just like so. Now, if you'll take a look up here at the top left-hand side of the Cricut Design Space canvas, as you can see, you can actually change the different types of the shirt from a men's short sleeve to a women's short sleeve, toddler, baby, so on. And you can also change out the size as well. Now I'm actually going to change this over to a medium. And now since we actually have that resize, I'm just simply going to resize our SVG cut file to whatever size I want it to be actually on our t-shirt. Now that template option that I just used, it is not currently available for Cricut Design Space on cell phones or on tablets. Hopefully they'll have that added on soon, but as it is right now, if you primarily use a cell phone or a tablet for Cricut Design Space, what you'll have to do is just take out the measurements manually on your shirt to know how big to make your design. But what I'm gonna do right here is grab this little recess handle at the bottom right-hand side of this image, just like so, and we can actually drag this inwards to be about the appropriate size we want it to be for that size of a t-shirt. Now, obviously these templates are not 100% accurate, but they really do help in giving you an overall idea of how big to make your design. All right, so I'm really liking the size of this design. So what I'm gonna do now is come up here towards the top right hand side of the page and click on Make It. All right, so this is the mat preview screen where it shows you where at on the cutting mat our design is gonna be cut out at. Now, since we are using this as somewhat of a stencil, I'm wanting this to be a little bit more towards the center of the vinyl so we have a little bit more margins around our design. So what I'm gonna do is just simply click this and then just drag this to the side like so. Now what we also wanna do is actually mirror this. Now I know that we're not using heat transfer vinyl, AKA iron on vinyl, but we're still gonna want to mirror this, which will make a little bit more sense here in just a little bit. So to do that, I'm coming over here to the left-hand side of the page and clicking on this mirror option, just like so. And now I'm coming down here towards the bottom right-hand side of the page and clicking on continue. All right, so here we are on the base material cut settings page, where we basically tell our Cricut what material it's gonna be cutting out and how much pressure to use and all of that. Now, since I am using the StarCraft HD permanent adhesive vinyl, what I always like to use as far as this setting goes is the premium vinyl setting. So for that, what I'm doing is come over here and selecting browse all materials, and then I wanna simply do a search for premium. And here is the premium vinyl option right here. So I'm just gonna select that and then come down here towards the bottom right hand side of the page and click on done. All right, so now I'm simply just gonna go ahead and load this onto our cutting mat and get started cutting. All right, so per usual, whenever I'm going to actually unload my vinyl from my cutting mat, what I always like to do is flip my mat over and then peel the mat away from the vinyl instead of the other way around. All right, so now I'm just gonna go ahead and weed out my vinyl. And to do that, I am using my pin weeding tool, this little guy right here. Now, whenever we are weeding this out, basically I'm weeding in reverse. Everything that I would normally pull off and remove, I am instead leaving behind and vice versa, because well, we are creating a stencil out of this. All right, so now we do have everything all weeded out like so. And what I'm gonna do now is actually just pull off some of this medium tack transfer tape. Now, what I like to do is actually just roll this out with the sticky side facing up towards me. Just enough to actually cover up our design. I'm gonna have to go ahead and just trim that out. Scoot that off to the side here and then flip my design over, flip my vinyl over, and then lay this down face first onto the sticky side of the transfer tape. And then just grabbing my little squeegee tool and then just burnishing this down really good. And then I'm flipping this over and then doing the same on the opposite. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is flip this back over and then peel the backing paper off of the vinyl. All right, so there we go. So there is our design, as you can see. And so now I'm just simply going to grab my little mesh screen. And with this mesh screen, as you can see right here, it says Speedball. Now this is the front, so to speak, of the mesh screen. What I'm gonna do is actually flip this over face down and then apply my vinyl to the backside of the mesh screen. All right, so right there is pretty good. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab my little squeegee tool again and then just burnish this down to the screen. And then what I'm doing is actually flipping this over and doing the same exact thing. All right, so now I'm just gonna flip this back over, and this will probably be the part that will probably test your patience the most, and it's the part where we're actually removing the transfer tape from the vinyl. So obviously the vinyl can't have a really good grip on the mesh itself, so we're gonna have to go really, really slow, and then if there's any pieces that's wanting to pull up with the transfer tape, we're just gonna have to go back in there and push those back down. I really do find that it helps if you pull this back at a really, really sharp angle. That seems to really, really help minimize anything that's wanting to pull up with the transfer tape. All right, so now I'm just gonna set this off to the side and save this for future use. And as far as this goes, I'm basically gonna go back over here and just try to burnish this back down as much as possible, because there are a couple of little air bubbles here and there where it kind of try to pull it up a little bit, but we'll take care of that lickety split. Now with this, you really want to make sure that any of the vinyl that is surrounding any of the cuts, you want to make sure that that part especially, more than anything else, is firmly adhered down to the mesh, because well, if it's not, well then we are definitely going to get some of that leakage up underneath of that stencil. All right, so that'll basically do the trick for us. So what I'm gonna do now is go ahead and grab some painter's tape and basically go over the areas that's not covered by vinyl, as well as try to cover up some of the sides or edges with this as well. All right, so this is all done. So what I'm gonna do now is just go ahead and set this off to the side and then go ahead and get our shirt and our easy press and all that set and ready. All right, so again, I am using my easy press for today, but you could also do this with an actual heat press. Now the time and temperature that we're gonna have to set this to actually set our design into our shirt permanently is 320 degrees for 40 seconds. All right, so this is the t-shirt that we are using today, and I am also grabbing a sheet of cardstock to stick inside of the shirt just to help prevent any of that ink from bleeding through the top of the shirt to the back of the shirt, just in case that were to happen. All right, so now I'm just going to simply grab our little mesh screen right here and then really just try to line this up wherever we want this to go onto our t-shirt. Now, me personally, I always like to place the designs around 2 to 3 inches or so below the collar. So that's exactly what I'm going to try to do with this. And you can really kind of feel the collar through the mesh screen if you kind of feel for it, and you can kind of measure it out that way too. You also really want to make sure that the shirt is kind of pulled taut and that there's no huge wrinkles underneath of this mesh screen, just because we want to make sure that this goes on as smoothly as possible. All right, so with this today, I am going to attempt like an ombre style of design. So for that, I'm using the white Speedball fabric printing ink or screen printing ink, as well as the yellow right here. All right, so basically I'm just gonna go ahead and grab my little spoon right here and then just scoop out some of this screen printing ink, just like so. And then basically, since I am, for this particular design, I'm gonna go from left to right, I'm just gonna drizzle it over here on the left-hand side of the design. And you really just want this to be as smoothed out and even as possible. And now right here for this section that we didn't cover, I'm gonna use some of this yellow. And I'm gonna have it overlap on some of that white just a little bit. All right, so now I'm just gonna go ahead and grab my little Speedball squeegee right here and then just drag this very firmly across the design. You also wanna make sure that with your other hand, you're firmly holding down the mesh screen onto the t-shirt. If you have another helper in your house, that would be most ideal. All right, so very carefully, all at once, I'm basically gonna peel this mesh screen up and off of the shirt. All right, so I can already tell y'all that I'm obsessed with this. What I'm gonna do now though, is actually go ahead and wash this out, clean all this out, and then hopefully by the time I'm done, this will be at least somewhat dry. If it's not fully dry, that's okay. I can take a hairdryer to it and then completely dry it before we actually heat set it in. All right, so this is just still a tad damp. So what I'm gonna do is just take a regular hair dryer and then just completely finish drying it. All right, so this is completely dry now. So what I'm gonna do now is actually stick my Easy Press mat inside of the shirt. All right, so now I'm just gonna go ahead and cover all this up with a Teflon sheet. You could also use parchment paper, but honestly, I just prefer a Teflon sheet. And from there, we just go ahead and grab our Easy Press or heat press and then apply medium pressure for 40 seconds at 320 degrees. Now, right about now, some of y'all might be wondering, well, why on earth would I do screen printing when I could just do HTV, AKA iron-on vinyl? And that's a valid question. The fact of the matter is, screen printing can be pretty cost effective and also pretty fast at the same time when you're doing a whole lot of the exact same shirt. So in reality, you could just move one mesh screen from one shirt to the next, to the next, to the next, and so on and so on. So if y'all like today's episode, or if you learned something new, it would honestly mean the world to us and help us out so much here on YouTube if you took just 2 seconds. That's all it takes, is 2 seconds to stamp that like button, as well as drop a comment down in the comment section below. Also, while you're at it, if you are new around here to the Design Bundles YouTube channel, well, then you may want to consider stamping that subscribe button and ringing that little bell for all the notifications, because y'all, they put out new crafty content, I'm not even joking, just about every single day. And I mean, who wants to miss a single crafty minute? I sure don't. Thank you all again so much for watching today's episode. It truly does mean the world to us. And until next time, stay crafty.